Hi, and thank you for joining me today. This is your friendly neighborhood librarian here again, and today we are going to be going over ASTM. So to get there, you're going to need to start off at the library homepage, and you can get there by going to our web address, library.pnw.edu, or using the library link that you'll find at the top of any PNW page. Now, you scroll down to the Find section. There you'll see the link that says Databases. Click on the Databases link. You'll be brought to the A to Z list, and since the database we're looking for starts with an A, we're just going to scroll down until we see it. And we're looking for ASTM, International Digital Library. If you happen to be off campus when you click on that link, it's going to ask you to enter your PNW username and password before allowing you to access this database. And if it's the first time you're accessing this database on or off campus on the computer you're using, you'll see this license agreement. Go ahead and click on Yes, I agree with the license. And then you're going to be brought to this search page. If you do run into any issues, try changing the browser you're using. ASTM is great for standards, and that is going to be what we primarily use this database for. If you're unfamiliar with a standard's an established norm or requirement. It's usually a formal document that establishes some kind of uniform engineering or technical criteria, methods, processes, and practices. These documents are prepared typically by professional groups or committees. They're believed to be good and proper engineering practices and sometimes contain mandatory requirements. Oftentimes, I hear from students that when they actually get into the engineering field, standards become much more important and are required in their work. If you find any useful here, I would recommend you download and save those. Standards can be pretty expensive when you do have to acquire them on your own. Okay, we've been looking up information about the racer, and in our databases, we were using terms that actually describe what the racer is and what it does. Lightweight, regolith, excavation have been the common terms you may have seen in the other videos. Well, when we're looking in our standards database, we do have to change that up. So we're looking for standards related to robots, and we're looking for a mining robot. So we're going to try the term robot and mining. We have 19 results coming up. However, we don't have any actual standards coming up related to robots and mining. Right? We have information showing up for our digital library, so we have book chapters, and we really want to use ASTM for standards. When you're looking for a standard, you need to think about the components that actually make up what you're trying to create. So maybe we just need to look for standards that are related to robots. And then when we get to the mining part, we look for standards relating to mining. And then we combine what we find into some kind of cohesive piece of information to help us make the robot we want. So let's get rid of the term mining. And we're getting suggestions on things we could look for. I'm gonna go for robot mobility. We are creating a foldable and very mobile robot. And I do my search. And now I have 62 results coming up. 37 of those are standards. We're doing much better now. If you take a look at your results, we have the title of the standard, which is giving us a quick idea what the standard is going to discuss. We have the standard designation after the letters ASTM, and we also can see that this is the active standard. It tells us active standard, latest version. We can also see that we have the active standard here, the latest version. It's telling us right there. If this was a historical standard, it would say that. And we do have a few different ones that are coming up. The designations are changing as well. And we browse through, we see what we can find. So we have test method for navigation when there's a defined area. We have it when there's combined area obstacles like stairs and landings. Speed. Okay, and you see that these standards are very specific to what we want these robots to do, and even the kind. So evaluating emergency response robot capabilities. Because we keep on getting results that are discussing emergency response robots, I'm gonna try adding in the word gravel. I think this is the kind of terrain that my robot is going to be dealing with, or at least that I want it to be capable of dealing with. Okay, and so the first result that we have coming up is the standard test method for evaluating response robot mobility traverse gravel terrain. We're being specific in the kind of standard that we're looking for, and we're actually getting a result. You need to think about your project in components when dealing with standards. So I know gravel is something I'm going to need to deal with. If you were constructing a pipeline, you might think of, well, what am I going to use to construct my pipeline? What's necessary? You might look up a metal or some other kind of specific element to what you're working with. All right, let's click on the title to view our standard. After clicking on the title, we can still see our title again at the top. Our designation is also at the top, and it's telling us this is the designation. It also says this is the active standard, again, providing us with that designation. After finding a standard that fits what you're looking for, you can actually just search that designation in ASTM in the future to pull up that specific standard again. We have the description for the standard, and then we have what's included in this standard here. You can download the PDF if you would like to save it to your hard drive. You can share it with yourself or someone else. You can use Cite This Document to start building that Works Cited page if you've decided you want to use this standard in your project. If you scroll down, it'll let you read the entire thing. And if you make an account with ASTM, it'll actually let you add and edit annotations in your browser. And if anybody in your team also makes an account, they'll be able to see those annotations, add and edit them as well. Okay, and if we keep on going, you can see the pictures, and they'll occasionally have diagrams as well to give you a visual representation of what you're dealing with. Okay, we're going to have information tables present, and then you're even going to have calculations present as well. Here you also have some test form illustrations that they used. And you can use all of this in your project. You just have to make sure you properly cite it. So this is ASTM. If you do have any further questions about standards, I would recommend talking with your instructor. And if you have any questions on finding standards, I would recommend you contact the librarians, and we will be happy to help you. Thank you for joining me.